Hi, I'm Jay Sellers with the Brunswick-Glynn Joint Water and Sewer Commission. Let's dig a little deeper into our water and wastewater processes and talk just a few minutes about inflow and infiltration. In an ideal wastewater collection system, all of the flow from your sink, tub, or toilet would make its way to one of our three treatment plants perfectly sealed from groundwater, seawater, and rain. When it rains and streets flood enough to flow over manhole covers, imperfect seals on their rims become drains for much of this rain. This is a process called inflow. Many of the homes and businesses in our community have what's called an upper cleanout, an access port close to your house, and a lower cleanout, an access port close to the street. Both of these devices facilitate snaking out any obstruction in the lines. If you're not aware of the things that shouldn't be flushed, like wet wipes, diapers, and paper towels, these cleanouts will come in handy. However, when you're done using the cleanout port, a special cap must be installed over the opening to prevent an inrush of water and debris. While not all inflow can be prevented, doing your part by replacing these caps will go a long way towards reducing inflow into cleanouts. Broken service lines also contribute to this excess flow. Each service connection to the wastewater collection system could become a drain for water that builds up in your yard. Despite our best efforts, material failure, age, and root damage can cause cracks to develop in the service lines and mains. These cracks can grow so large that as much as half of what gets treated at the plant isn't coming from your house or business due to greater amounts of groundwater entering the system. That's referred to as infiltration. Water always takes the path of least resistance. Any crack in your service line or our main creates a void where water or dirt will be anxious to flow. Over time, these cracks become bigger, often leading to dips in your yard or sinkholes in the street. Having to treat this extra rain or groundwater contributes to repair costs on the pipes, higher power bills and maintenance costs on the pumps at stations that are used to get the sewage from an area of lower elevation to a higher elevation in the gravity sewer system, and leads to reduced capacity in the treatment system overall. At the least, all of this extra processing energy increases the cost to run the wastewater treatment plants, leading to an increase in the operations expenses and ultimately impacting your bill. In an effort to reduce the likelihood of our systems becoming affected by this type of added waste, we routinely run camera equipment through lines large enough for the electronics. This equipment allows us to maintain a video record of the exact location of breaks, cracks, and roots in the mains. Where we can't run this equipment, we pump a type of smoke that is safe for the materials, the environment, and your health into the system, exposing damaged lines and check valves anywhere the smoke pops up where we don't expect it. We have an active and systematic asset management program that helps management and the Board of Commissioners prioritize and budget for any needed repairs to the public system. If damages to your private plumbing reveal themselves, we will contact you to provide details for what steps must be followed to ensure that you're able to quickly reduce your contribution to the inflow and infiltration dilemma as well. During especially heavy rain or high tide conditions, you may find that your tub or sink drains slowly. Please keep in mind that some areas within our service districts are under review for repair, while others are presently getting updates that can help reduce or resolve this issue. We have over 330 miles of gravity sewer main and over 150 miles of pressurized main. Because of our limited elevations in Glynn County, you'll find that our close to 6,800 manholes connecting the gravity system are assisted by close to 240 pumping stations. When your power is out, our power may be out too, though we do have a limited number of gas or diesel-fueled bypass pumps and generators that can help keep the waste flowing. When a service outage is widespread and our staff is not able to maintain this flow, we will post notice on our website to give any instructions that may be necessary to help reduce the likelihood of problems. In some cases, especially regarding precautionary boil water advisories or major road closures, we utilize an emergency notification system known as Everbridge to send you service-related notifications within minutes of us identifying a problem. Please visit our website and click on the red Get Emergency Service Alerts button to get these critical alerts. Every day, the staff of the JWSC is here to serve you.